You probably know Blender uses a lot of keyboard shortcuts. Here's everything you could want to know about keybinding and keyboard shortcuts in Blender, including how to find, edit, and create new custom keyboard shortcuts. My name is Brandon, let's get started. As with so many things in Blender, there are more than one way to change and add custom keyboard shortcuts. First, let's start by looking at key mapping in the preferences. Go to Edit, Preferences, and choose the Key Map tab. We'll get into this search feature in a second, but below we have some high-level preferences that can be changed, such as whether we want to use the right or left mouse button to select, and which action the spacebar performs. Below that, we have a long list of groups of keyboard shortcuts. This is because keyboard shortcuts in Blender can do different things in different parts of Blender. For example, a shortcut might do something in edit mode, but do something different in object mode. That same shortcut might do something entirely different in another editor, such as the video sequence editor or the geometry nodes editor. These folders can get confusing because they're almost every action imaginable in Blender, and it can be hard to find the shortcut we're looking for. So let's go back up to that search bar at the top. There's a toggle switch here with the options Name and Keybinding. With Name selected, we can search for an action in Blender by its name. For example, let's search for Bevel. We see that Bevel appears a few different times here, and in two different categories. Under Mesh, these are the shortcuts which apply in Mesh Edit Mode. The first one, Control-B, is a standard edge bevel, and this other one, Shift-Control-B, performs a vertex bevel. And down here, this Drag Left Mouse shortcut is for when we have the Bevel tool from the toolbar activated. When this Bevel tool is activated, we left-click and drag to bevel. That's what these different shortcuts are all about. If we clear this out and instead select Key Binding, this is where we would search for the actual keys used in the shortcut. For example, we can type in just B, and we see every shortcut in Blender that uses B on the keyboard, whether that's just B, Control-B, Alt-B, Shift-B, etc. As you can see, there are quite a few. If we type CTRL space B, then we get a shorter list of those which use Control-B, and we do see that our bevel shortcuts are up here at the top. If we expand the arrow next to any shortcut, we see all the possible instructions behind the shortcut, many that I don't pretend to understand. This is the specific action the shortcut affects. This is the type of interaction, meaning does the shortcut apply when the key is pressed, when it's held, when it's released, etc. And down here are the modifier keys used in this shortcut, such as Shift, Control, Alt, etc. Let's go back to Name Search and type in Bevel again for this next part. On the right of each shortcut, we see an X icon. Clicking this, of course, removes the shortcut, but you almost never want to do that. Let's say we wanted to simplify the bevel shortcut, and instead of it being Control-B, we just want it to be B in order to save a keystroke. We could expand this shortcut again and click to remove the control from the shortcut. Now it's just B. Alternatively, and this is probably easier, we could just go here and click where it says Control-B. When we do, it changes to say press a key. Now, Blender will record whatever key combinations we press. So, if I just press B on the shortcut, it will change the shortcut for me. Press Save Preferences to save your changes. Now in the 3D viewport, in edit mode, I no longer have to press Control-B, but rather just B to bevel the selected mesh. That's nice. Of course, be careful that you're not changing the shortcut to something that's already assigned to something you use in that editor and/or mode. I've got more, but if you've made it this far, I'd love it if you hit that like button. Much appreciated. Thank you so much. One more thing here in the preferences. See how the X icon next to the shortcut we changed has now become an arrow? One, this shows us we've changed the shortcut from the default. And two, we can click the arrow icon to revert back to the default shortcut for this action. So here's another and maybe more practical way of adding a keyboard shortcut, especially to something that doesn't already have one assigned. Anywhere in Blender where we have something that's a button, a checkbox, or a specific action we are telling Blender to take, we can assign a shortcut. There are hundreds or more places that this could be done. For demonstration, let's just look at a couple. In the sidebar under the View tab, there's a checkbox for Lock View to 3D Cursor. I normally keep this on by default, but let's say I wanted to add a shortcut. I'd right-click the checkbox, and in the menu, choose Assign Shortcut. Then we get a box that says Press a Key. I'll press D for some reason. Now I hit D on the keyboard. It toggles this setting on and off. We've added a shortcut. We can right-click again, and now have options to change the shortcut or remove the shortcut. And here's a useful one. Let's say I add array modifiers to objects all the time. Like, I add them to everything. So frequently, in fact, that I want to do it with just a single press of a button. In object mode, select an object. Go to the modifier properties, choose add modifier, go to generate, and we find our array modifier. Right click where it says array, and boom, assign a shortcut is an option. I'll choose D again. Now when I have an object selected in object mode, I can press D on the keyboard, and it automatically adds an array modifier to the selected object. You'd be surprised at how many things have this option available in Blender. Remember, we don't want to use a shortcut that's already assigned to something else, at least something else that we use. Doing so will overwrite the old shortcut. So we can go to the preferences and search to see if the shortcut is being used or not. I did a little research, and as of the time of this recording, it doesn't look like D, colon, or apostrophe are used for anything in Blender key mapping. So those should be available. And there are lots that are available if you add Control, Shift, or Alt to it. One step further in this process is to map shortcuts to really obscure key maps and then program those into an external keyboard or a device like the Elgato Stream Deck, which I love and use all the time. Its buttons can be dynamically programmed to do different things depending on the program you're using at the time. The LED displays will change, and you can create folders that open up other shortcuts. This thing is a game changer for those of us who use software like Blender, Adobe Suite, and other shortcut-intensive programs. Check it out with the link in the description, because I get a small referral at no cost to you, if you buy one. I hope this answered all of your questions about keyboard shortcuts in Blender. Subscribe so you don't miss future tutorials and tip videos.